incredible public servants in this community, the assistant DAs, the support staff, people who I describe it simply as this. My job is to support them so they can serve the people of this community. And I've just been tremendously privileged, and I want to thank each and every one of you for the work that you do every day to serve this community and make it safe. Well, thank you. You know, another piece of advice I got when I was first elected back in 2006 from my predecessor was, keep a low mortgage. Keep a low mortgage. And what he meant by that was simply this. What he meant was, you're going to have to make tough decisions. And that's what he said. John, sometimes you're just going to have to make a tough decision, and it's not going to make people happy. But you have to do it from a place of principle. You have to do it from your integrity. You have to do what you believe is right. And then you have to let the consequences fall where they are. I would hope that that's what you want out of your district attorney. You don't want somebody that's going to make decisions based on what they think is going to be popular, or certainly not because they're intimidated by people that are trying to do things that are going to dissuade you from doing the right thing. It won't happen. It never will happen as long as I'm the district attorney of Milwaukee. This would not have been possible, quite frankly. So if I look back at January and where I was then, it simply would not have been possible without everybody in this room. Every single one of you has played such a critical role, because I really started basically from nothing. I hadn't raised money, I intentionally made the decision I wasn't going to do that because of all the dynamics that were surrounding money and politics and our office. I decided I was not going to do that, but then I realized that we had to fight. We had to make the fight. And so I had to start somewhere. And I just have to start by thanking Chris Abley for being the first person to step forward. And then even long before Chris, Dr. Pam Malone. She quite frankly, she says she started my campaign 2 years ago. And then everything just started. You know, all the relationships that we've built together over time. You know, the IBW folks, the labor council, every single one of you just pulled together. You know, right from grassroots on up. You know, we got support from literally everybody that recognized how important this office is to maintaining not just the integrity of the criminal justice system, but having the opportunity to serve people. So at the end of the day, what's been unique about the challenge I've faced here is what? Is that, sure, we've been flooded with dark money, but what is the natural attack that's been made on me, right? It's that I'm soft on crime, I'm doing all these things. Look, I also made a commitment 10 years ago that I was gonna do certain things with that short time that I was given. I was gonna try to make a difference in this community. And certainly I have an obligation to hold violent people accountable, and we do that each and every day. And nobody in this state, no, quite frankly, nobody in the country does it better than our prosecutors with the help of our support staff and with our incredible relationship with the community and with our investigators and police departments. All of that is essential to what we do. But I also believe that we could do different things as well. I thought that we could do a better job of identifying people that were drug addicted, mentally ill, that were alcohol dependent, youthful offenders, and trying to get them in places where they could actually change that behavior without filling up our jails and our prisons. So I made that commitment, and I've lived up. Anything I say I'm going to do, I'm going to do. I believe our solutions have to be based in the community. I believe that we have to work closely with our business community and everybody else to really change the dynamics of the neighborhoods and the families where our problems arise and where eventually we have to deal with them in the criminal justice system. Nobody in this room wants that. That's what I just have to stress again and again. We're committed to serving this community, and nobody here would feel like we hadn't done that job if nobody was walking into the courtroom every day. That would be the ultimate goal, is solve our problems in a way that doesn't rely on the back end of the system. So I'm committed to doing that. I'm going to continue to work on that, not just at the local level. I'm going to work on it at the national level as well, because it's, this is the issue of the day, right? The relationship of our community with law enforcement is an issue not just for this community, but for the entire country. And we can do this. We can actually do this as a country. Again, to all the electeds that have supported me right from the start, you know, you had Gwen Moore backing me up on this. You had Chris, you had Tom Barrett, you had Ashanti Hamilton. You just go down, all of you in this room, you know, and even though judges aren't allowed to participate in a partisan election, I had such tremendous support from the judges and the defense bar. The defense bar and the public defender's office have been absolutely essential. And if there was any insinuation in any way, shape, or form that my opponent was unworthy because she had done defense work, I'll just make it perfectly clear that that's never been my approach. It never will be. Every single one of us are colleagues in the same fight, and that's to create this a more just community, and that's what we're going to do in the future. So thanks to all of you. So I'm gonna wrap it up, but I can't wrap it up without first bringing my wife Colleen up here, because so we celebrated our 25th wedding anniversary on August 1st, and I got her what I always got her, which is nothing. We were doing something on the campaign that time, but the reality is this is that Ted loves this stuff. Ted loves this stuff. Colleen never signed up for any of this, but she has been there for me every step of the way. I've always been the same level of obsessive intensity on some things, and I know it takes a toll, but I simply could not do this job without her. And to all the spouses in the room, all the family members, for those of you engaged in this profession, thank each and every one of you for all your friends and family, because we can't do it without you. Looking forward to serving this community in the highest way that I possibly can. You've got my complete commitment, and thank you very much. So,